Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech. And yesterday, Apple released macOS Big Sur Beta 11.0.1. And this is a bit of a surprise because macOS Big Sur is not yet out to the public. So this is available to developers and beta testers. And as you can see here, came in at 3.69 gigabytes. This is on a 2016 MacBook Pro. So if I close this, you can see version 11.0.1 and the build number is 20B5012D. Now, like I said, it's kind of odd because beta 10 is what we had with version 11, but now we're already on the next version. So many of you are asking me, how do I go from this version to the public version when it comes out? Well, if Apple releases the public version very soon, do not install this update, but rather revert back to the previous one. So what you want to do is kind of stay on beta 10. So go to your system preferences. Under system preferences, go to software update. We'll wait for it to check for an update. It won't find it, but down here on the left where it says software update, go to details and hit restore defaults. This will remove you from the beta program and you'll be on beta 10. When the next update comes out, you'll be able to update to it. The only other way to do it is to manually restore and go back to the previous version. So I'm not exactly sure why they did it this way, but they did this time. And so if you don't want the current most up-to-date beta, don't update to this version, at least from what I can tell from the documentation. Now, as far as anything new in this particular update, well, there's a bunch of bug fixes and known issues, and I'll talk about that in a moment. But if we go into settings or system preferences, and then we go to desktop and screensaver, there are updates to the actual photos or wallpapers that are in here. So we'll give it a moment to load. It's kind of doing something strange on this MacBook, but you'll see in addition to what we had with beta 10 last time, there's some new wallpapers. So if we switch between them, it takes a moment, it switches. These are all dynamic. And this one is Catalina, but it's dynamic. They've just changed the way it looks. Then we have the cliffs. And I showed this one last time, but there's some new drawn ones as well. So that's the Pacific Coast Highway. You'll see here's a new one called the lake. We have the desert. We'll wait for it here. We also have the beach. And then we have solar gradients. Now these will change throughout the day. Now we also have new ones here for peak. Then we have tree. Wait for that. Then we have valley. And also dome. And then there's some additional ones as well. So Apple keeps updating these. Some of these you're familiar with, so I'll skip over those. But some of the newer ones, you can see here's Big Sur Mountains, Big Sur Aerial, Big Sur Coastline, which I had at the beginning of the video. Let's see if we can go back to it. That's kind of odd. We've got Big Sur Shore Rocks. And then Big Sur Water's Edge. They're all very nice. And then Big Sur Road, Big Sur Night Succulents, Big Sur Night Grasses. And then we have the Catalina wallpapers. So here's a few others. Peak Day. If we go down here, you've got Catalina Silhouette, some others. Peak Day, Peak Night, and some additional ones as well. So there's quite a few throughout here that they've changed it to. So I think they're really nice. This one I like, Dome Night here. So you've got a bunch of different wallpapers, drawn or not. I kind of like this one for now, Big Sur Coastline. So we'll stick with that. So we've got a bunch of new wallpapers. I know a lot of people were wanting new wallpaper. They're beautiful photos. And if you have a high resolution display, they look great. Now, the other thing is there is references to new Macs within the code. So Apple's Silicon Macs should be coming later this year. And 9 to 5 Mac, as you can see here, it says Big Sur 11.0.1 beta includes references to three unreleased Macs ahead of Apple Silicon. So we're waiting for those particular updates, whether that be MacBooks, MacBook Pro, or iMacs. We'll have to wait and see, but we know that they're going to refresh the entire lineup of Macs over the next couple of years. So we should see that soon. Now there's 29 known issues, and some of them have to do with Bluetooth. For example, you may be unable to pair certain Braille displays using Bluetooth. So if that's important, don't use the beta, but you can see here's just some Bluetooth preferences. I'll show that in the menu bar also. And then also when you're updating from macOS Big Sur 11 beta 2 to macOS Big Sur 11 beta 3 or later, you may have a huge download rather than an incremental software update. And then also you want to keep your Mac awake if you're installing this update according to Apple, because it may go to sleep and you don't want it to do that. So you'll need to adjust that in your energy saver, and you can do that. Here we go to power adapter, and you don't want to turn off the display or anything like that. Prevent it from sleeping. That way it installs the update. And then other than that, there's a total of 29 known issues. So they're still working on it, but things from the kernel to Swift UI, third-party apps and more, and they've resolved 6 issues as well. So it seems pretty stable so far. I've been using it on this Mac, and I'll also be using it on others. So it seems like it's doing okay. It's fairly fast. This is only a dual core Mac, but you'll see it's fairly fast considering that I'm screen recording at the same time, but in general, it should be pretty good. I'll link these wallpapers in the description below. I believe a couple different people have already posted them, so I'll link them so you can try them out. And some people have modified them for iPhone as well, so I'll link those. If you've found anything else though, let me know in the comments below. Some people are saying there's a new startup chime for different Macs. I haven't heard that. I don't have one of those Macs that I've noticed a difference, but let me know if you've found anything else in the comments below. Also, let me know if you'd like to see more of these macOS updates, even if there are only a few small changes like I mentioned already. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.